Ladies and gentlemen, if you could please take your seats, we are about to get started. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Great to have you with us. If you could just take your seats. Welcome to a very special occasion. It's the 2022 NBL One South Awards, proudly presented by Basketball Victoria. My name's Jason Bennett. It's my great honour to be your Master of Ceremonies this evening, alongside our fabulous co-host Megan Huswaite, who will be joining us shortly. And we'd like to begin by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land, the Wurundjeri people, and pay our respect to the elders, both past and present, of the Kulin Nation, and extend that respect to other Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Australians present. Well, NBL One South continues to go from strength to strength. NBL One commenced in 2019 as a replacement league for the CBL. It's evolved into a conference system in 2021. Queensland and Northern Territory in the north, South Australia in central, Western Australia in the west, and this year NBL One East in New South Wales. And tonight, as we head for NBL One South finals here this weekend and the national championships next weekend, we celebrate the efforts and achievements of players, coaches, staff and volunteers in NBL One South from Victoria, Tasmania and Mount Gambier. And there's certainly plenty to celebrate in what's been a hugely successful season. We welcome the Keilor Thunder and the Casey Cavaliers. More than 186,000 fans attended matches, with Knox and Melbourne attracting more than 2,300 to their clash. We welcome the first female coach in the NBL One South Men's Conference, Sam Woosnam. And we saw a new home stadium for the Eltham Wildcats and a renovated home court for the Diamond Valley Eagles. A new app, more than 30 million minutes of viewership nationally, with 1.6 million streaming viewers, 8 new referees and some big milestones there as well. So there's plenty to be proud of. And to formally welcome us to tonight's proceedings, please welcome the Chief Executive Officer of Basketball Victoria, Mr. Nick Honey.
Thanks, Jason, and good evening, everyone. After what has been an extremely challenging few years, it is a great pleasure of mine that I'm standing here welcoming you all here today, this evening, for the awards dinner, with one more day to go to complete what has been a momentous season for NBL One South. We've truly bounced back. The basketball has been fantastically competitive. The attendances and the streaming, as we've just heard, the numbers have been through the roof. So we're really proud of what we've achieved given the previous couple of years through lockdown. And really, it's a credit to everyone involved. It's a credit to the passionate and hard-working players, the coaches, score bench, stats, referees, administrators, managers, and all the game day staff and association volunteers. It's also great to see here tonight representation from all our clubs and associations. So again, thank you so much for your passion and support for our league. As I said, as we get to the business end of the season, and tomorrow we'll see the crowning of the NBL One South Conference with the grand finals participated in by Bendigo and Ringwood in the women and Mount Gambier and Hobart in the men. And we wish all those teams the very best. We also acknowledge that the winners of those games will go on to the national finals here at this venue in 1 week's time. And we want them to be representing the South and to win it for the South. We also acknowledge the Frankston men who have won the wildcard entry in, and we wish them the very best as well. Also want to take the opportunity to acknowledge and thank our league advisory panel who volunteer their time to plan and assist with the development and oversight of the league, provide great insight and great support for us. And it would also be remiss of me if I didn't acknowledge and thank our league manager, the passionate, caring and incredibly hard-working Alison Cody. So please, hands up, Alison. Finally, in conclusion, congratulations to all the award winners tonight, who will be announced throughout the evening. We've enjoyed the spectacle of such great talent on display all season, and hopefully tonight is an opportunity for us to celebrate the best of the best. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Nick, and well done to you and your team on all the hard work that goes in behind the scenes to help and grow, develop NBL One, and those numbers that we mentioned, quite extraordinary. It's wonderful to see. This is one of the fastest growing sporting competitions of any sport in Australia. And that includes, as Nick mentioned, our league advisory panel, Laurie Chiswick, Mark Hallett and Tim Motten all involved. They're all here tonight. Great to see them. And the panel members will volunteer their time to support the league. And we'll see Laurie and Mark up on stage throughout the night presenting some awards as well. Speaking of which, it's time now for our first set of awards for the evening, our stats-based awards, which recognise the league's leading performers in the various different stat categories. To be eligible for these awards, a player must have played at least 75% of their team's matches during the season. And joining us now to help present these awards, one of Australia's leading basketball journalists from the NBL One show, rather, should be courtside for the big games coming up this weekend. Please welcome Megan Huswaite.
Thank you, Jace. Good evening, everyone. Great to see you all here. Small girl problems. Great to see you all here as we celebrate a complete NBL One season for the first time since 2019. Isn't it fabulous to be back? Great to be at the home of Victorian basketball, the State Basketball Centre. I'm sure there's some people in the room that were with us for the awards in 2019 at a nightclub on a Sunday morning. And it was a wonderful occasion, but it's much nicer to be here at the State Basketball Centre. Well, let's get into our first awards for the night, and we're going to start with the Golden Hands Awards. This award is determined by adding assists and steals and subtracting turnovers from a player's statistics. The Golden Hands Award winner for the women in NBL One South from the Bendigo Braves is Kelly Wilson.
Oh, McLean with a nice steal. Is Kelly going to take that? She's going to wait for the troops and then throw it into a double team engage.
Just bully the man out of the way.
Get out of the way. It's 22 from the Hulko. She also has 9 boards, only 1 turnover. Anthony Ardu has the captain, 7 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists. It's Kelly Wilson.
Kelly Wilson, a living legend of women's basketball. Put your hands together for her. Now, if we don't have our award winners with us tonight, would a representative from their club please come and accept the award? Now, our Golden Hands Award winner for the men from the Frankston Blues, Lucas Barker.
Johns can't score. Referees letting it get physical here in Frankston. Stife out in transition. Goes the up and under. And now.
Well, that was NBA distance, that one.
That was quite the attempt. Now Barker goes one on one to the rack. Count it.
15 seconds to play. They just need a bucket.
And one. And one.
Lucas Barker, everyone. Now, we love a Froling, and we were lucky to have all 4 of the Frolings play in the league this season. And our winner of the leading rebounder for the women from the Launceston Tornadoes with 14.24 rebounds per game is Killy Froling.
Oh, Froling left wide open.
Great work there by McCauley to keep that ball alive on that offensive phase.
Kylie would be very happy at the first 5 years of her career you've ignored for a bit of youth.
I have some stories on that, by the way.
No doubt.
Back out at 21. Little pass over to Froling. Good defense from Parsons. Froling puts and it up, one. Makes it. And one. Okay.
Keely can't be with us tonight, so would you please welcome her twin, Alicia Froling, to accept the award. Alicia, Keely doesn't have to know. Our leading rebounder for the men from the Bendigo Braves, Siddi Kite. There you go, congratulations. 13.53 rebounds per game for Siddi. To our leading scorers now for the women, would you please welcome back Alicia Froling to accept for Keely Froling with 29.57 points per game. And our leading scorer from the men, he'll be part of the grand final tomorrow night for the Mount Gambier Pioneers, Michael Harris, with 24.62 points per game. Congratulations to all of our leading statistical winners in 2022. And Jace, it's back to you.
Thanks, Megs. Congratulations, as Meg said. Well, next up, our referee awards. And to help present these awards, it's my great pleasure to welcome the General Manager of Leagues and Competitions for Basketball Victoria, Greg Jeffers. Greg, if you'd come forward to help us present these awards. Well, one of sport's great truisms is there's no game without the ref, and our referees and officials play a critical role in the running of NBL One South. And Greg, obviously, that comes under your department. Come across here and just tell us a little bit into everything that goes into it in terms of referee numbers and pools and time and effort. It's a big job.
Thanks, Jason. Yeah, look, it certainly is. And I've got a shout out to Ruben Woolcock, who's here with us, who leads the way for our referee team. It's often referred to about accountability and all that kind of thing, and I can certainly attest, having been in here for 4 or 5 months now, that Ruben certainly does that, and the old saying of no ref, no play comes into play. But certainly Ruben has done an outstanding job in terms of development and appointments and planning for our referee team. So big shout out to him.
Well done, Ruben. All right, it's time to present our NBL One South Women's Conference Referee of the Year, as adjudicated by our referee coaches, led by Ruben. And the winner of our NBL One South Women's Conference Referee of the Year is Bianca Vernon. What, no highlights? Well done, Bianca.
Thank you.
And for all our award winners, I probably should have mentioned, we've got a photo area set up across on the side here a little later on. So when we get through this first block of awards, everyone who's collected an award tonight, if you could just head over there and we'll get some official photos for the website, and for obviously for those who couldn't be here tonight, we can send those to them as well. Now to our men's award. The winner of our NBL One South Men's Conference Referee of the Year is Daniel Batty. Good on you, Daniel. This year, we're introducing a new award, the Golden Whistle, which gives our players and coaches a chance to recognise our officials for their game management and their interpersonal skills in a demonstration of respect that is shared by all participants in our game. The criteria for the Golden Whistle includes conducting themselves in a manner reflective of the standard of NBL One South, displaying strong communication and interpersonal skills, possessing the key attributes of a basketball referee, and has worked a minimum of 25 games in the regular season, displaying commitment and investment in our sport. And Greg, if you would please come across and do the honours, the winner of our NBL One South Golden Whistle.
Carly Trist.
Well done. Congratulations to Carly and to all our winners in our first block of awards. Thank you to Greg Jeffers. And again, thanks for all the hard work that you and all the officials and referees put in to make NBL One South a success that it is. Well, ladies and gentlemen, dinner will be served shortly, so we're going to take a break, allow you to circulate, catch up with people, and we'll be back with more awards shortly.
Who needs the hot shoes when you've got? to our reporter when she's ready. We're going to do it in front of one of the media screens.
She'll come in through here.
Thank you. taken by a professional photographer, instantly want to get the selfie as well. Like, I once took, like, a nice photo of people, and then they said, like, oh, can I just take a picture of it from the back of your camera? And then they posted that. They just want to post it straight away. They're like, a picture of your photo displayed on the back of the camera was good enough. Just get it out. Because in Adelaide, everyone's drinking. The commentators, like, have beers brought to them by the CEO.
Oh, really?
But I don't think that's normal everywhere. I think that's very much a culture that comes from a state where the main industry is wine. What do you think, James? Photos here, so probably the one that's just up there.
Maybe that one.
Oh, you do?
So I'm looking there for months and we're like, okay.
Okay.
and welcome back to the NBL One South Awards Night Dinner here at the State Basketball Centre. Megan Hustrate with you. We're going to call it halftime. It is the dinner break, but we've got some of the biggest names and stars of the NBL One Conference here in the South joining us for a bit of a chat. First cab off the rank from the Geelong Supercats is Liam McInerney. Liam, great to see you. And how good is it to have a night like this?
It is. I think everyone's enjoyed the fact that we've been able to actually get through an entire season uninterrupted. So to have something like this to celebrate it, it's probably what everyone wants and everyone needs, I think, after such a long couple of years.
Yeah, it's been a long time between full seasons and awards nights. Now, you had something to celebrate recently with a big milestone, Siebel and NBL One combined. So congrats on that. It's a lot of games.
Yeah, cheers. Yeah, it was a long time coming. I feel like I probably could have hit that mark perhaps a couple of years ago if it wasn't for the pandemic, but I've got through it and I'm still feeling good and just looking forward to the next milestone.
What about the Supercats? How would you sum up your season?
Unlucky, to say the least. We definitely had a top-notch roster right at the start of the season. We were definitely up there as contenders and we were sitting on top of the ladder for a number of weeks. But as the season went along, we lost various pieces. I was just saying to some of the people here, I've never been in a season where we've had so many injuries, sickness, and even guys being picked up in the NBA affect a single season by a single team. So it was very unlucky on our part, but that's right. We can always build for next year and hopefully be able to build a very similar roster.
At NBL One in NBA, it's a pretty good story for Jaguar.
Yeah, I like to tell people that we were the springboard onto the NBA, but we might have skipped a few steps in there.
Now, the men's grand final here tomorrow night between Hobart and Mount Gambier. Your tip?
I'm going to go with Mount Gambier. I just appreciate their style of game. It's very hard to play against, very hard to guard, as is Hobart, not to take away from theirs, but both teams extremely well coached. I think the dynamic nature of most of the Mount Gambier players just makes them very hard to guard.
There you go. Tip from Liam McInerney. Thank you for joining us. Have a good rest of your night.
Thank you very much. You too.
Thank you. As we bring in Harry Froehling now, speaking of the Chargers, who will be playing here tomorrow night in the grand final, one of their stars for Hobart, of course, is Harry Froehling, who joins us now. Harry, thanks for joining us. This is a bit of interesting prep the night before a grand final.
Yeah, I mean, come have a few waters and sit down, enjoy the company, talk to people and... it's been good, so enjoying it.
Looking forward to tomorrow night. Where do you think the game will be won for Hobart?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it's going to be a heck of a game. Mount Gambier are super talented. Harris and Marshall have been playing real well, so it's going to come down to, I think, the scout and all that sort of stuff and who executes it better. So it's going to be one on the defensive end because obviously they're a high-scoring team and so are we. So if we can knuckle down and do that, I think we should get it done, but it'll be a heck of a game.
Now, we had all four Froehlings in NBL One this season, three in South, which was good, and we've seen Keeley take out some statistical awards tonight. Will we see Froehlings feature for the rest of the night, do you think, across the award category?
Yeah, I think you will, obviously. I think I've had a half-decent season, so I wouldn't be surprised if I see myself get an award, hopefully. I've got my criticisms of the system, but I think we'll see a few awards for the future Froehlings that are going to come up tonight.
Okay. Well, thanks, Harry. Have a good night on the waters and good luck tomorrow night.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Harry. As we bring in another star of the NBL One South competition now, from the Ballarat Miners, that's where she's played her best basketball this season, Jade Melbourne, everyone. Good evening, Jade.
Good evening. How are you?
Save the best to last. Yeah. Jade, great to see you. It's nice to come together and celebrate the league after a completed season.
Yeah, it's cool. You know, everyone's here tonight, see all the award winners. It's been a really good competition this year, so it's good to see everyone in the one room and we can celebrate all the successes of people. So, yeah.
Now, I've got a soft spot for Ballarat, being from Ballarat. It was great to see you in the Miners uniform this season. How did you enjoy your campaign?
So good. Ballarat as a whole is just unbelievable. People there are great. Selkirk Stadium, their new stadium's unreal. And we had a really good group of girls. Unfortunately, didn't make finals, but I had a heap of fun up there. Loved every minute of it.
Now, you won the Robin Maher Award for MVP and she presented you in Ballarat, which was so lovely to see that photo. That must have been special. Obviously, a legend of international Australian Victorian basketball, a Ballarat export and a former Opals captain. That would have been special.
Yeah, I mean, to get recognised as MVP is always an honour for your team. And then to have someone of her calibre present it and be in her name, it was really cool. I didn't realise she was there until I bumped into her, had a chat with her superstar on the court. So yeah, it was a real honour to receive it from her and the award being in her name.
So women's grand final here at the State Basketball Centre, 5 o'clock tomorrow. It is the Bendigo Braves, another regional team, taking on Ringwood. Who's your tip?
I mean, it's going to be a good game and I hope it's a great contest. But I just think Bendigo have been the best team all year and I think they're going to win it tomorrow night.
Okay, so Bendigo from Jade Melbourne. But let's talk the extra important question now. Melbourne are playing Sydney in a qualifying final tonight. Jade Melbourne goes for the Melbourne Football Club. You know it makes sense. Have you been checking the scores? What's going on?
I actually haven't checked the scores, okay. You know.
We'll check.
I don't want to get too nervous or anything. Have a look right now. I hope the D's are up.
Let's go to the AFL app. It could take a minute. It's not as good as the NBL One app.
We're lucky this is a good night because I should be there right now, but...
Yes. Okay, so... 2-1-13 apiece. About 6 minutes to go until quarter time, of course. It is a late... 7:50 start, of course, or 7:40 start, which is late on a Friday night. So the D's, hopefully they can get it done for Jade Melbourne tonight. Jade, thanks for joining us and enjoy your night.
No worries. Thanks for having me.
Good on you, Jade. Well, thanks for joining us for a few chats with some of our stars of the NBL One South Conference. It's time for dinner here at the State Basketball Centre. We'll be back with you on the live stream soon as we continue on with all our award winners to come tonight. Of course, coming to a head with our MVP winners for both the men's and women's conferences. We'll see you soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you could please take your seats. We're going to continue with our formalities in just a moment. Thank you. Time now for our next block of awards. And legendary American college football coach Bear Bryant once famously said that offense sells tickets, but defense wins championships. And these next awards celebrate the NBL One South's premier defenders as the NBL One South Defensive Player of the Year Awards. Now each club nominates, thanks ladies and gentlemen, each club nominates its best defensive player, and that group of nominees is then voted on by the captains and coaches. And we will begin with our Women's Defensive Player of the Year. And the winner of the NBL One South Women's Defensive Player of the Year for 2022 from the Ringwood Hawks, it's Digna Stroutman. Over this side, there you go. Megs, you want to go over and get a photo? Yep. Excellent. Well done, Digna. Congratulations. Now to our NBL One South Men's Defensive Player of the Year and the winner from the Sandringham Sabres, Shay Illy. Coming forward to collect Shay's award on his behalf is Dave Barlow. And congratulations in order for you too, Dave. Did I read during the week the retirement? Congratulations, mate, on a phenomenal career. Ladies and gentlemen, what a career, Dave Barlow. Well, legendary American songstress Whitney Houston once famously said that I believe that children are our future. I'm not sure what that's got to do with this, but this next award celebrates the NBL One South's premier youngsters. It's open to players under 23 years of age at the end of the season. And it's also voted upon by our captains and coaches from a shortlist compiled from the weekly voting of coaches and referees. It's the Youth Player of the Year. And we will begin with our Women's Youth Player of the Year and the winner from the Ballarat Miners, Jade Melbourne. I'm just right here dancing around to the rhythm that you play when you break in my heart. You know that I can't get you out of the system. Yeah, right from the start, you play with my heart. I'll be singing la 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 la. You're breaking me la 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 la.
Well, Jade Melbourne, congratulations. Another accolade to go in your growing collection. How did you enjoy your debut season with the Ballarat Miners?
Yeah, thank you. It was awesome. Ballarat's such a great club, great people involved. Stadium facilities there was unreal. It was kind of everything I was looking for in the off-season. Great group of girls. Unfortunately, didn't make finals, but I had a great year.
What was it like to play under Herbie? It's a familiar name in basketball circles for all he's achieved. What was it like to be coached by him this year?
Yeah, it was awesome. I was with him at the under-19s. I'd never been coached by him before, and when he said he was going to Ballarat, I just wanted to learn more from him. So, yeah, to learn from him and his little sidekick, Caleb, he's here tonight, so I'll give him a shout-out. it was awesome. They've really helped me become more of a well-rounded player, and, yeah, he was unbelievable leading our group.
Well, it's been an incredible year for you. You were selected in the WNBA draft, so would you put your hands together for Jade? She'll be heading to Seattle next season. You've played for the Opals. One of your goals this year was to go on the New York camp with the Opals ahead of the World Cup preparation, and you ticked that off. So what was that like to achieve?
Yeah, it was super cool. When I answered the phone call, I couldn't really believe it. But, to go over there, train alongside Lauren Jackson, who we know is about to dominate the World Cup. The group's awesome. So, just to be amongst them, learn from them was unreal. And I can't wait to see what they do in 20 days. 20 days, yeah.
20 days. Yeah. Finally, Jade Melbourne, you are Melbourne by name and nature. You are a huge supporter of the Melbourne Football Club, who are playing in their qualifying final tonight. It's a very nervous evening for you. Is the phone getting a workout over there at the table?
Yeah, before I came up, we're up by three. So
down by one.
Oh, down by one? Oh, no. I better go get back and get around.
You better get back there. Would you please congratulate Jade Melbourne, everyone?
Now to our NBL One South Men's Youth Player of the Year and the winner from the Eltham Wildcats, Owen Foxwell. I'm gonna build castles.
Owen, congratulations. Jason's right. It's a wonderful segment of the night because we get to highlight and celebrate two young guns of the game. Owen, you're certainly one of those. How was the NBL One season for you with the Wildcats?
I loved it. I had a great opportunity at Eltham. I loved all the boys. It was a great season. I know we didn't get as many wins as we would have liked, but it was a great opportunity for me. The coaching staff was awesome, and everything about it was awesome, so I really liked it.
So we know you're coming off an NBL campaign with the Phoenix, where in the throwdown you actually started, which was a fantastic opportunity. What have you been working on in terms of your own individual game this NBL One season?
We started pre-season about a month ago, kind of just becoming more of a point guard, getting more people involved, which I've tried to bring to my game a bit more. The guys at Phoenix have also made a big chance to try and get that better in my game, so I'm just trying to develop that.
And who was the best guard that you played on in NBL One South this season?
Probably Shay Ely.
Yeah. it's hard to go past Shay.
He's unreal, so yeah, probably him.
Awesome. Congratulate Owen Foxwell, everyone. Thank you. Well, our next awards, ladies and gentlemen, recognise and acknowledge coaching excellence in NBL One South for 2022. And they are our Coach of the Year awards. They are voted upon by, table 14, by our captains and coaches. And we will begin with our NBL One South Women's Coach of the Year. And the winner is Matt Sutton from the Mount Gambier Pioneers.
Dance for me, oh-oh. I never seen anybody do the things you do before. They say, move for me, move for me, move for me, hey. And when you're done, I'm dead, you do be thought again. They say, dance for me, dance for me, dance for me, oh-oh.
Well, Matt, congratulations. Took the Pioneers to third place, a 15-7 record. A force to be reckoned with at the Ice House. How was the season with your girls?
Yeah, good. It's lucky I can coach because they're awful people that I coach.
They're shocking, aren't they?
A nightmare to be around. Beautiful people. The community is so supportive. We've got a really supportive board. Everything that the club does is in support of what we can achieve on the court. And we've just got fantastic players that enjoy each other's company, and I feel very fortunate to coach them.
Now, it's probably hard to pick out the most memorable win because you had some fantastic victories throughout the season. But Shaq Riley putting up the shot against Frankston, I'm sure that would have to be up there in terms of celebrations for wins this season.
It is, and it's sort of, it'll be a memory of the, you know, the Ice House, our home ground, which in the future it's likely we won't be playing there with the new facility coming. But that place is electric. For anyone that got the experience to play there, it's something happens to people in the crowd, and if there's a very good game like there is, everyone goes a little bit bananas, and thankfully the camera was where it was because, you know, I was sort of having a seizure in the corner going crazy, but pulled it together in time.
Now, another amazing achievement for you during the season, you reached 250 combined games for your club as a player and a coach. So could we put our hands together, because that is a sensational achievement. What do the Pioneers mean to you?
It means a lot. You know, and first of all, I didn't know 215 combined. I didn't know that was a thing. So I appreciated all the videos and messages because I'm a very ego-driven person that likes attention. So it was nice to have that at the time. But the Pioneers means a lot. It was 2010 when I moved there. It was supposed to be for just a couple of years, just to do something a little bit different in my life, and next minute I'm here coaching the women's team. My beautiful wife is down there in support, and we've got
the real MVP.
And you know, we're building, and I've got a house down there, and it means a lot. The community and the club mean a lot to me.
It's lovely to hear. Now, we will be back here tomorrow night for the grand finals. Unfortunately, your Pioneers won't be there. It is Bendigo and Ringwood in the decider for the women. I've got to ask you for a tip.
Let's go. Yeah, nah. I think our heart, based on the fact that Ringwood's beat us, I think it's going to make us feel a lot better about ourselves that when you guys get the win. And definitely in the men's, the Pioneers.
Of course. Matt Sutton, everyone, could you please congratulate our Women's Coach of the Year? Thanks, Matt.
Thank
Congratulations.
You.
Now on to our NBL One South Men's Coach of the Year. And the winner from the Kilsyth Cobras is Peter Godfrey.
My diamonds leave with you. You're never gonna hear my heart break. Never gonna move it sideways. Baby, you're so cruel. My diamonds leave with you. Material love will fool me. When you're not here, I can't breathe. Think I always knew. My diamonds leave with you.
Looking very sharp too, Pete.
Thanks very much.
Congratulations. I guess, first of all, how incredible was it to get a full season? Thank you. I'll sing. That will quieten the room. How good was it to get a full season after two COVID interrupted years following your appointment?
Yeah, it was big. We talked about that as a group, actually, and I think I could probably speak for everybody in the room that doing three pre-seasons to get the half a season last year and to kind of get the full season this year. So, you know, given how much work everyone in the room does in terms of players, coaches, administrators, everybody, it was great. Fantastic. Yeah.
The Cobras were consistent in 2022. You probably went under the radar in the minds of some because there weren't all the bells and whistles like there were around some other teams. But what was the key to that consistency?
Just the way we like to coach it and the way that the group is. We were fortunate we had eight players on our roster that either played juniors there and or youth there. And then the ninth in that group was Tim Lang, who'd already played 200 senior games there as well. So we used to use the slogan homegrown, my first go round at Kilsyth, and we didn't quite put all of those signs and stuff back up. But the fact that we had eight guys on our roster that had been Cobra juniors was phenomenal.
Yeah, that is incredible. We asked Matt about what his club means to him. What does Kilsyth mean to you, given that you've had a few stints there and a long involvement?
Yeah, Kilsyth means a lot. I actually come from the other side of town, so I do 100k round trips four times a week to get there, and I love the place. For those that know me, I'm a motorcycle rider. First bike I had, I did 120,000 Ks on it, and 100,000 of them were Kilsyth Ks. So I love the place. If anybody, and I think Bendigo's here, I can't see with the lights on, but full credit to you guys too for the way you rolled this year. If you were anywhere near our stadium, and I mean probably within about four blocks of our stadium on Friday night, that's probably what Kilsyth means to us in terms of the crowd, the faithful. It was just an absolute cracker. So it's a great place to coach, great place to play, the boys tell me. And, you know, front office, game night army, it's great, really good.
It's lovely to hear that. We can't let you go without getting your tip for the grand final tomorrow night, Hobart and Mount Gambier.
I haven't seen the Gambier guys or the Hobart guys. I don't know if Stewie was here. I'm going to Switzerland. I'm claiming Switzerland. What I do hope, though, A, it's a good contest and it's injury-free, because I know a bunch of the guys are going off to do other things in terms of the NBL and stuff. So have a cracker, fellas. We're sorry we're not there. And just, yeah, play hard, play well. Be good for the sport and be injury-free.
Yeah. Good message. Would you please congratulate Peter Godfrey, everyone?
Thanks, Pete. Well done.
Jace, it's now time for Club of the Year.
Club of the Year. So our Club of the Year award factors in the following criteria: game day ratings by away coaches and referees, player experience ratings, best game night rating from player surveys, the best stadium rating from player surveys, streaming views and attendances at home games, combined ladder positions at season end, and compliance with financials and admin deadlines. And we would like to welcome Basketball Victoria CEO Nick Honey back to the stage to announce this important award. It's our NBL One South Club of the Year for season 2022.
Very pleased to announce the Club of the Year for 2022 is Knox Basketball.
Congratulations. A lot goes into this award, as we mentioned. All those different criteria, so I'm sure there's some people you'd like to thank. The floor is yours.
Absolutely, cheers. Well, thank you very much. Listen, it was a tough year for us. As you know, we've got a big stadium to fill. We worked really hard this year to increase our participation. We wanted our players to, you know, really fill the atmosphere, and you know, having 500, 600 people in a venue for some is really good, but we have to get, you know, a lot more than that. So I think we averaged over 2,000 per game, which is pretty cool. So I wouldn't be able to do it without my staff. I've got amazing staff here. So I thank them for the way they do it. The players, amazing. You know, we put the show on for you guys. The Knox board, you know, I just had so much support this year to be able to do what we wanted to do. We went out there, you know, we ran a lottery, we gave $10,000 away, we opened up the doors free, and, you know, it works. So, yeah, we're pretty proud of ourselves for doing what we did. So, thanks.
Congratulations. Cheers. Congratulations to Knox, the Club of the Year for 2022. We're going to take another quick break, just a short one this time. We'll be back with our final group of awards. Still to come, our All-Star Fives and our MVPs. We'll see you shortly. Ladies and gentlemen, if you could please retake your seats, we're going to finish with our final awards of the night, the All-Star Five and the MVPs very shortly. It's time now to announce our NBL One South All-Star Fives for season 2022. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you could please take your seats. It's my great pleasure to welcome League Advisory Panel member Mark Hallett to the stage to make the presentations. Our referees and coaches lodge their votes after every game across the season. The names of our top 20 vote-getters are then sent to the coaches and the captains who vote 3-2-1 to form our All-Star Five. We will begin with our NBL One South Men's All-Star Five for 2022. From the Sandringham Sabres, Shea Illy. From the Mount Gambier Pioneers, Michael Harris. From the Hobart Chargers, Harry Froling. And if you're in the room, feel free to come up and grab your award. From the Diamond Valley Eagles, Dejan Vasiljevic. And from the Bendigo Braves, Kwani Kwani. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our men's All-Star Five for 2022. Shea Illy, Michael Harris, Harry Froling, Dejan Vasiljevic and Kwani Kwani. Now to our NBL One South Men's MVP for season 2022. A prestigious award that goes to the league's most valuable player as voted by our referees and coaches after every game. Those five gentlemen we just mentioned are our top five nominees. The winner of the NBL One South Men's MVP of 2022 is Shay Illy of the Sandringham Sabres. Coming forward to collect Shay's award is Dave Barlow.
Dave Barlow, coach of the Sabres, thank you for accepting on Shay's behalf. Believe that he's had a little mishap at training and couldn't join us tonight.
Yeah, unfortunately, Shilly yesterday at Melbourne United training copped a stray elbow to the head and has a concussion, so he's out of action for about a week and not wise for him to attend tonight. So sends his apologies.
Well, he's had an incredible season. It's been your first season coaching the Sabres. When you can bring in a player and a person like Shay Illy, it's a pretty big coup.
Absolutely. Obviously, as all of you have played against him or with him can attest, he's a brilliant player. Absolutely amazing human, teammate. Loved having him. Incredibly grateful to have him at our club. And I think he's fully deserving of this award for sure.
So across 16 games for the Sabres this season, he averaged 23 points, 5 rebounds and 5 assists. And we take into consideration that he started late because of NBL. He's had New Zealand national duties and managed to produce a season like this. It's a fair achievement.
Yeah, absolutely. When he was with us, it was an absolute luxury. Would have loved to have him towards the end of the season in playoff time, for sure. That was quite unfortunate. But just everything he brings to the team, to the club, all of his teammates love him. He shows up to training, normally carrying both his daughters, one in each arm. He's carrying a green Woolworths bag with all their toys and stuff. And he just endears himself to everyone who comes into contact with him. And again, I'm incredibly grateful to be around him.
When he was with you this season, what impressed you in terms of what he was producing at this level?
I mean, I was fully aware of what he could do on the court. I think what to me was most impressive, the way he, and I'm sure his teammates over there could attest to it, the way he, you know, helped nurture the young guys on the team, the way he endeared himself to all his teammates, immersed himself in the club, the culture. You know, he's just a brilliant bloke all around, so that's probably what impressed me the most.
Very popular winner. Well, while we've got you here, Dave, we'd like to congratulate you on your basketball career. With the news yesterday, you've announced your retirement. So would you put your hands together for Dave Barlow, everyone, an incredible servant to the game, both on and off the court. We know you'll continue at United, but we hope you've got the coaching bug and we'll continue to see you with the Sabres in NBL One.
Yeah, appreciate that for starters. Thank you very much. And yes, you'll see me running around at NBL One for sure.
Excellent news. Would you please thank Dave Barlow accepting the MVP on behalf of Shay Illy.
Now we turn our attention to our NBL One South Women's All-Star 5 for 2022. And joining us on stage to make the presentations is another member of our league advisory panel. Please welcome the great Laurie Chiswick. So let's do our All-Star 5 to begin with. Same voting system as with the men. Refs and coaches lodge their vote after every game. The names of the top 20 then get sent to the coaches and the captains. They vote 3-2-1 to form our All-Star 5. From the Knox Raiders, Alicia Froling. From the Bendigo Braves, Tess Madgen. Yeah. from the Launceston Tornadoes, Keely Froling. From the Nutterwood Inspectors, Alice Kunick. And from the Ringwood Hawks, Marina Whittle. Cause I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop, but my heart goes bum, 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 cause my heart goes bum, bum, bum. A round of applause for our women's All-Star Five, Alicia Froling, Tess Madgen, Keely Froling, Alice Kunick and Marina Whittle. That now brings us to our NBL One South Women's MVP for season 2022. This award goes to the league's most valuable player as voted by the referees and coaches who lodge their votes after every game. The five women we just mentioned are our top five nominees. Laurie, if you'd like to come forward and make the announcement, please.
So there were a lot of great players playing in the women's competition this past season, but the most valuable player award for the Women's 2022 NBL South goes to, and she can collect her own award, Alicia Froling from Knock. Well, Alicia, this is your moment. Does it make it a little bit sweeter because you pipped your twin, Keely, for this award?
It's definitely sweet. always competitive between me and Keely, but she obviously had a really great season. Probably helped me a little bit that she's got Kelsey Griffin and Mariana Tolo on her team to probably steal some votes, but definitely sweet.
It's a remarkable MVP story, and all MVP wins are. But you changed the hand in which you shoot.
Yes.
This season. And you've had a horrid run of wrist injuries.
Terrible.
For years.
Yes.
And you decided you were going to use your left hand. At the end of the season, you've won the league MVP.
It's actually 3 years to the day since my last wrist surgery. And it's been horrible. Mentally, just physically, my body not doing what it wants to do. I actually was probably pretty close to giving up on it. So 10 days before our first game, actually, I just said, stuff it, I'm going to use my left hand. And now I'm shooting threes. And, you know, if you had told me that I was going to be up here at the end of the, I probably would have been like, maybe not. But it's pretty special. It's been a massive turnaround.
It's a massive achievement, and I think you shot a three early in the season. You kind of surprised yourself because you hadn't hit one since, I think, your college days.
Yeah, it's probably been 4 years. My wrist, just there's nerve damage, and it's not good. But I think that was about 3 weeks after I decided to change hands. So, it's just been a massive turnaround for me, and I have to thank my teammates. They've had so much belief in me, and like it's been the most fun that I've had playing basketball in so long. So thank you, girls. I love you, and yeah.
So you win the league MVP. What confidence have you got now heading into a WNBL season? You've signed with Bendigo. You've played under Kennedy this season at Knox.
Yeah.
Yep, table 14 are very happy about that WNBL signing. And you'll play under Kennedy in a consecutive season. So how are you feeling heading into WNBL?
I'm feeling amazing. I think, you know, the last two seasons have been, really, really rough for me. But I cannot wait. I think it's going to be a big year. I think what we've got going on in the spirit is going to be awesome. So I'm really, really excited.
Now, from a famous basketball family, as we know, your parents, Shane and Jenny, champions in their respective leagues,
the kids now all playing in WNBL, NBL and then NBL 1 this season, which has been fantastic. Harry's here tonight. Keely's watching on the stream. And Mum and Dad, Shane and Jenny, are watching on the stream from Townsville. So
yeah.
Describe to us the Froling household, the four kids growing up, and just how competitive it was in the backyard.
Very competitive. I think that people probably don't understand, but like it's down to, you know, who has more chocolate milk in their drink, like down to the millimeter. Everything is a competition. Even now, you know, we talk who's the better driver, who's the better, you know, it just, we can't help that kind of stuff. So it's very intense, but it's a lot of fun. And obviously, you know, Harry had a really great season too. Keely, obviously, I mentioned. And then Sam's doing his stuff with the Boomers. So it's just nice to see us all have a little bit of success. And it's nice to be up here with this trophy.
You are the winner tonight, April. Would you please put your hands together for our women's MVP, Alicia Froling?
Well done, Alicia. Wonderful performance. Great story. Well, that wraps up our formalities this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to all our winners. Thank you to all our referees, our scorers, our statisticians, officials and volunteers who are the lifeblood of NBL One. The league couldn't thrive without you. To all our players and coaches, thank you for another season of entertainment. Best of luck to those still in championship contention. On behalf of Megan, I'm Jason Bennett. Thanks for your attention. Enjoy your evening, everyone. Get home safe. Thank you.